to see an woman character. A
father, Samson Ozogula.
Samson Ozogula. Right? So you have this, those are the players I was going to see in XYZ game, right? Good players, talented players. But right now, it's absent. It's absent. So it still boils down to our coaches, our local coaches. Bring out something from whoever you see, and the person will reproduce. See, like my club, we started doing that. We say, in fact, what we're doing right now, we're looking at the younger players, the youth system. To the glory of God, two of our under 17 boys now they're in national team. You know, they just went there over the weekend. Look out for these two boys in the next 2-3 years. Because we carefully selected them. So this is what we should start doing. Produce them. Yesterday I played on All-Stars football. People were watching, they were saying, man, won't you go and screen on that club side? I said, man, the skill is still there, but the strength is no longer there.
Your passes.
Yeah, you know. So we do not have that type of game.
We blame the coaches or the structure or we blame the lack of system, the structure, programs and all of that.
Everything.
Yes.
Everything. Because let us see. If you ask me, we should forget about super egos for now. Let's say we do not want to qualify for a Nations Cup. We don't qualify any World Cup. Let us start afresh. Check out USA, what USA is building. Towards 2026 World Cup. So let us have that kind of program. Let us have a 10-year program. You know, we will produce world beaters in Nigeria. Not from outside. Resident here.
Mm.
Give them different tasks. That is those people that will go for such selection. Well paid. So that they will not be moved by anything outside their remuneration. You know, make them comfortable. We will get players and we'll groom them better.
That encompasses a whole lot of things. That includes nutrition, it includes the psychology, it includes facilities, the pitches, you know. I was watching a game with my son and I was saying, Daddy, why is it that when they pass the ball in Europe, the ball goes to where the pass, you know, is intended to go. In Nigeria, the ball bounces, you know, and all of that. I mean, shouldn't also place that on the, I don't know, even for Ugbo Stadium, I think Uyo, the pitch in Uyo is also getting bad. Abuja has gone bad, you know. So what are we doing about facilities?
I think we need to do a lot of investments in our facilities and in our sport generally. That has been lacking over the years. What we only aim for is the glory. Oh, the under-17 has won African edition 2020, under-18 has won world edition, and because we do shortcut measures. Look at the progress since 1985 that the world the under-17 in China up to now. Has it translated to success at the Super Eagles? No, because we cheat the system. Most of them don't grow up to our national team to become stars because they fizzle out during the way. So investments in our facilities, investment in our players, and of course money needs to flow down. It doesn't need to stay up at the NFF level. Because that's what I see in Nigeria. Everybody comes to the NFF, we don't say anything. What about our league system? The league has refused to resume after the lifting of restrictions. Money needs to go into this league if you want it to function, because players will be tested. The money there, at the facility there to test the players. Look at Europe, they test them every week. Players, officials, everybody. Do we have money to sustain that? So we need a lot of investment, private sector investment, sponsorship. There was a time that sponsorship issue, and then after that we lost it in the Nigerian league. No sponsor for the Nigerian league. How do clubs play their players? How do clubs make money? How do they break even? These are the critical things we need to. If we can get it right at that level, it is functioning well, a vibrant league, the clubs are doing well, they will naturally produce players. But if you don't do that and go at the top level, NFL level, and go to Europe and look for any player of Nigerian name to bring the Nigerian game, they are not going to get it.
As I ran this interview, LMC came to my mind, bright idea and all of that, but I think at some point they lost steam and all of that. You don't think that's also responsible for the lull we have in the domestic league now?
No, I don't think so. You see, the LMC, the football does not begin and end at the LMC level. You know, we have the NNL. We have the NLO.
Yeah. Yes.
So let us take it from bottom to the top. Not from the top to the bottom.
Like what you are doing at FC Milayo.
Exactly.
I think some football administrators too have not also been very, very sincere with what they do. Sometimes they say they are recruiting players, that are of, under 18 players, under 15, and what you see are players that are, you know, close to 30.
You see, that has been a major issue in Nigeria. But you know, when we're in government in Ogun State during Togbagbo Daniel, I was in charge of the under 15, right? And we did an open screening. They will ask players to come to your birth certificate. You know what I was told then? Some people said they gave birth to them in a mosque. So they don't have birth certificates. And I know too, there was only one time in secondary school, he also cheated. You see, how do we get it? In Nigeria, Ajebota's do not play football. And these are the ones that use their real age.
D-O-B's. But they're the ones that are playing horse now. Okay, is an Ajebota. Akpoguma is an Ajebota.
At home. So the issue of age cheat is left for another day. Like my friend, my brother, my boss, because by the way, the Commissioner of Sports in Ogun State, he championed this age cheat matter. I know a lot of people came to him and said, Oga,
you can't
leave
it to, you can't leave it to,
now he is hustling, he's a hustling.
So, we have machineries.
So the edge sheet of the thing, if we start it now, we won't finish it.
We won't finish
that discussion on it.
Okay, well, call this part one of the discussion, because there is no way you want to talk about the falling qualities of the Super Eagles of Nigeria without doing part one, part two, part three, part four, because if you bring in some other gentlemen here too, they also bring in other perspectives to the issue. But then we have to call it a day at this point. And I must thank you so much for coming. President FC Nilayo, AB, thank you so much for joining us. Okay. I don't know what happened yesterday. I was able to drag you out.
Pleasure. Thank you very much.
You're being head of sports, OGBC. Thank you so much for coming.
It's a pleasure being at the program.
Okay, that's the program this morning. New Dawn on the People's Telly, OGTV, 25 UHF. We'll see you again next Monday. Of course, our colleagues will also return on Wednesday for another edition of this program. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.